You know, the halachot that we learn each day, we try to connect it to the times that we're in. Right now, we're in between time, between the time of Hanukkah and Purim. And it's called the Arizal enacted that there will be 6 weeks of fasts between these two festivals in the Jewish calendar. And the Shovavim is a time of tshuva that's comparable to the time of tshuva in the month of Elul. That there is a time before Rosh Hashanah that we prepare for tshuva on Rosh Hashanah. And so too in the winter time we have the Shovavim, a time of fasting and tefillot that will give us, prepare us for Purim and Pesach. Okay, so this is a very special time of year, and here at Nar Shalom, people fast on Mondays and Thursdays, and then there's a whole series of prayers that they say, and the reciting Tehillim. And all of it, of course, is to arouse us into tshuva, to return to Hashem. So we see that throughout the Jewish calendar, there are various ways that the rabbis are inspiring us to do some kind of tshuva. It might be on big things, it might be on little things, but nonetheless, if anybody's in Jerusalem and they ever happen to be near the Shuk and near the Yeshiva Nar Shalom, I'm sure they would find it inspiring, because it's a time where they take out the silver shofars, the silver trumpets, they blow them, and they do hakafot around the Sefer Torah, and it's quite inspiring. You feel like it's a little bit of Tishrei or Elul in the middle of the winter. So anybody, no, not everybody can fast like that. These are day fasts, meaning from the morning until the evening, about 12 to 14 hours. Not everybody is strong enough to do that, but nonetheless, they could still do the limud or even a portion of the limud. And this just brings up an important feature, I feel, in Judaism, that the rabbis have given us very, very high standards to achieve. To keep a kosher life is not an easy thing, because there are laws that apply to every single thing that we do as Jews. However, God knows us and He knows what we're capable of. And our job is not to finish the work, as it says in Pirkei Avot, rather to make efforts as best as we can. And the efforts might be simply to say an extra prayer on a Monday or the Thursday, or to have a little bit of, even to skip one meal, just to be able to feel that feeling of emptiness within one's stomach. And that little bit of pain is a kapara, that an atonement that we all can benefit from. So it's very good to be in sync with the Jewish world, even if I can't keep all the laws that are being enacted at that time. I could keep Shabbos at the level that I keep Shabbos, and not everybody could keep Shabbos at the same level. But the most important thing is that we're part of the consciousness of the people, that we as Jews keep Shabbos. Now, what level? That's up to the individual, his education, his background, his ability, his diligence, his blessing. And nobody is the same as anybody else. So we're not here to judge each other, but rather we're here to join each other and to use the Torah as a tool, a document that's designed to unify us and not to segregate us between more religious, less religious, holy, unholy. This type of segregation, that's only God's job. That's His business. But rather, our job is to appreciate each other for who we are, regardless of how religious we are, if we wear a kippah or have a beard, and all the other thousands and thousands of laws that we can keep as religious Jews. So with all that said, in the time of the Shovavim, we are preparing. The winter months are considered months that were given over to Esav, given over to the powers of darkness and the powers of constriction. We see that the earth itself corresponds to this pattern, that the earth is in stagnant mode during the winter for the most part. The animals go underground and sleep, that trees go to sleep, that plant life is diminished during the winter. All these are symbols or signs of the constriction of the months of the winter. Whereas, of course, the summer is the opposite, the time of expansion. And the summer, of course, those months, we say, are designated to Yaakov. So this parallel distinction between Yaakov and Esav is a paradigm for us to look at also the entire Jewish calendar and the cycle of a year between the ecliptical orbit that we are find ourselves in, where during part of the year we're closer to the sun than others, and those times of the year that we're further from the sun in the winter, as in now, it's a time for regrouping, rebuilding, preparing for the spring.